Welcome to the U.S. Food and Drug Administration's presentation series on complex innovative trial designs, often referred to as CID. In this session, I'll discuss the CID pilot meeting program process. The landscape of drug development is evolving, and with this evolution, there is an increased need for novel clinical trial designs that allow greater efficiency in a range of therapeutic areas. To promote innovation, FDA has launched the CID pilot meeting program. So, what are the anticipated benefits of the pilot meeting program? Hallmarks of the program include innovation, collaboration, and education. Advancing the science of trial design will more efficiently bring safe and effective products to the patients who need them. Providing more treatment options to patients is the ultimate goal of CID. This 5-year program is a goal included in the 6th iteration of the Prescription Drug User Fee Amendments, often referred to as PDUFA 6. The program is a joint effort of FDA's Center for Drug Evaluation and Research and Center for Biologics Evaluation and Research. Under the program, sponsors may have the opportunity to meet with FDA regulatory staff, including statisticians, to discuss a CID proposal. FDA will select up to 2 CID meeting requests per quarter, giving priority consideration to meeting proposals with highly innovative trial designs for which analytically derived properties may not be feasible and for which simulations are necessary to determine trial operating characteristics. On August 30, 2018, FDA announced the CID pilot meeting program in the Federal Register with the following eligibility criteria. First, the sponsor must have a pre-IND or IND number for the medical product or products included in the CID meeting proposal, with the intent of implementing the CID in the medical product development program. Second, the proposed CID is intended to provide substantial evidence of effectiveness to support regulatory approval of the medical product. Third, the trial is not a first-in-human study, and there is sufficient clinical information available to inform the proposed CID. Fourth, and this is a unique aspect of the program, FDA and the sponsor must reach an agreement on the trial design information to be publicly disclosed. The CID pilot meeting process consists of 6 steps. 1. Sponsor submits a CID meeting request. 2. FDA evaluates the CID meeting request. 3. FDA notifies sponsor of their status and whether they will proceed to disclosure discussions or FDA will deny the meeting. 4. FDA and sponsor discuss disclosure elements. 5. FDA and sponsor reach a disclosure agreement and FDA grants the meeting. If no disclosure agreement is reached, FDA denies the meeting. 6. Sponsor granted their meeting request participates in 2 CID meetings with FDA. Let's walk through the process, looking at some of the finer details. Here's an approximate timeline for the CID pilot meeting program process. Notice that sponsor process steps are highlighted in yellow, FDA process steps are highlighted in gray, and joint FDA sponsor process steps are highlighted in blue. FDA will receive meeting request proposals on a rolling basis each quarter, with a meeting request proposal deadline at the end of each quarter. For example, March 31st, June 30th, September 30th, and December 31st. The Federal Register Notice and the CID Pilot Meeting Program website include the required timelines for several of the steps. Within 45 days after the quarterly closing date, FDA will review submissions and will notify sponsors if their meeting requests will proceed to disclosure discussions or be denied. The 2 CID meetings granted will be held within the span of approximately 120 days. The initial meeting package is due 30 days before the initial meeting, and the follow-up meeting package is due 90 days before the follow-up meeting. In this discussion, we will use the terms Meeting 1 and Initial Meeting interchangeably, and the terms Meeting 2 and Follow-up Meeting interchangeably. Now let's talk about the meeting request proposal process. A CID meeting request proposal must include the elements shown on this slide and the following slide. Notice the highlighted meeting request elements. These are unique to the CID meeting request proposal. A brief rationale for the choice of the proposed CID, the simulation plan, and the elements of the study design that the sponsor considers non-disclosable, along with a rationale for the exclusion. Now we'll touch briefly on the next step in the CID pilot meeting program, FDA's evaluation of the CID meeting request. During the FDA's review of the CID meeting request proposals, initial priority will be given to trial designs for which analytically derived properties may not be feasible and for which simulations are necessary to determine operating characteristics, for example, type 1 error. Other factors that FDA will consider are therapeutic need, trial design appropriateness for the CID pilot meeting program, level of innovation of the trial design, and the value proposition of the CID. Within 45 days of the end of a quarter, FDA will select up to 4 meeting requests, 2 primary and 2 alternate meeting requests, to proceed to disclosure discussions. FDA will then notify sponsors of their status. FDA will send a meeting denied letter if the meeting request will not proceed to disclosure discussions. The next step in the CID pilot meeting process is the disclosure discussion between FDA and the sponsor. The goal of the disclosure discussion is for FDA and the sponsor to agree on which elements of the study design are disclosable. This agreement is a requirement for the CID pilot meeting program, as FDA may publicly present aspects of the study design and analysis developed through the pilot meeting program as case studies before approval of the therapeutic product studied in the trial. Once an agreement on information disclosure is reached, acceptance into the CID pilot meeting program will be granted, and FDA will send the sponsor a meeting granted letter with meeting dates. If FDA and the sponsor do not reach an agreement on information disclosure, FDA will send the sponsor a meeting denied letter. This slide shows some of the potential elements for disclosure. There are 4 final steps in the pilot meeting process. These are the sponsor's submission of the first meeting package, the first meeting being held, the sponsor's submission of the second meeting package, and the second meeting being held. The contents for the initial meeting package are listed here. We've highlighted the initial meeting package components that are unique to the CID pilot meeting program. These include a detailed simulation report and overall conclusions, with a brief summary of the simulated operating characteristics based on design features and analyses, and a discussion of the utility of the CID given the simulation results. The Federal Register Notice of August 30, 2018 further describes the required components of the detailed simulation report. So, what needs to be included in the follow-up meeting package? Here's a list. We want to highlight the need for updated programs or shells for simulations if applicable. This requirement is unique to the CID pilot meeting program. FDA will send a meeting summary following each meeting. For more information on the contents of the meeting packages, visit the CID website. Please note that processes may be revised as this pilot program evolves. Updates will be communicated on the CID website. We have now concluded our brief overview of the FDA CID pilot meeting program process. How will we know that the pilot meeting program has been a success? We anticipate there will be many indicators of CID pilot meeting success as the program facilitates and advances the use of complex adaptive, Bayesian, and other novel clinical trial designs. But the most important may be the benefit to patients, because the CID pilot meeting program promotes the development of innovative designs and analyses that may advance new therapies across a diverse range of areas of need. We hope that this brief overview of the CID pilot meeting program process has been helpful. For more information on the CID pilot meeting program, visit the FDA CID website or submit questions via email to cid@fda.hhs.gov.